My name is Emmeline Blanchard. We are at the Georgia Institute of Technology in Atlanta, Georgia, and I am a first-year biomedical engineering graduate student going for my PhD, working in Dr. Philip Santangelo's lab. I just started recently, so I'm just beginning my project, and so far it looks like it's going to be working on using the RNA probes that we use in the lab for imaging, and using it both to image RSV, which is respiratory syncytial virus, I think that's how it's pronounced, to both image it and look at its cell process and also see if we can inhibit its translation transcription and therefore stop the virus as a therapeutic. I am from a suburb of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It's called Coatesville, but it's about an hour outside of Philadelphia. My brother has severe food allergies to a lot of things that are like really deadly. And so when I was super little, I wanted to have a bakery that was going to be safe for him, all foods he could do. But then as I actually learned subjects, I decided I was going to be a doctor, like a medical doctor. But then I realized I'm kind of squeamish, and so I would not actually enjoy the doctory aspects of doctor, even though I wanted to help him out and people in general. So then I moved into the biomedical research because it was a way to develop things that could really help a lot of people, just like, for example, like the EpiPen, which my brother's had to use in case of anaphylactic reactions to save his life, things like that. And that's why I wanted to be able to create things like that. And my research interests have changed from the EpiPen back when it was first done, but it kind of brought me into the research side of things. I really like the fact that the lab is very friendly and like we interact a lot and talk a lot. Like I said, I'm new to the lab, so I just joined. So most of my time I've been here so far has been kind of shadowing people and like learning the techniques from them. They've been very helpful and very welcoming and like immediately welcoming me in, like we all go out to lunch together and stuff, but also like being very willing to teach me things. And like if I'm unsure, like I'm using the microscope by myself for the first time, I'm like, hey, can you check this for me? Make sure I'm not messing it up. They're always very willing to help. I'm a little bit more interested in research that has the potential to like be therapies and stuff and make it out into the clinic and really change people's lives. So I think my mission, I guess, would be to help create something that could actually affect people positively. It's a good career to consider because it's a huge field. It's growing. It's not like you're ever going to reach the ultimate knowledge of everything we know about the body and everything that possibly affects it. I mean, I guess in theory, at some point you can reach it, but not anytime soon. So it's not going to be stagnant. There's always going to be something new to learn. So it's going to be an interesting career. And there's going to be opportunities for it because as a population, this is something we really need. It's not like there's never going to be not a need for fixing disease and things like that. So I think practically it's a good field to go into. And I just also think it's fascinating. I've learned so much, even things I'm not as particularly interested in classes, it's still cool and it's still things I learn. So I'm always learning new things and learning new techniques, and it's also a really dynamic field itself. By the nature of it, because it's about research, it's a lot about connecting and community. So it's a lot about, you meet a lot of different people and it's always kind of like sharing the knowledge and making connections and spreading it. So there's like seminars every week that you can go to and learn more things about. And that's not just as a student, but also once you reach your actual career, to my full knowledge, I haven't gotten there yet, but that continues. And it's all about like people you know, you talk to someone over in California and you share ideas and spread it. So it's kind of a cool, you're not an individual. It's all, even between your lab, your university, and across the world, it's very much a community of trying to better the world and learn more and how much can we learn from it. And so my favorite part, I think, is kind of that potential. I haven't gotten very far in it yet since I'm just starting, but the potential to keep learning and keep doing new things and making new connections, I think, is really exciting.